Hey guys, my name is Jason with Mount Baker Mining and Metals, and today we're going to be running our PCB grinding system behind us. We have a customer that sent us a sample of his electronic waste that he's shredded. There's quite a bit of fine copper wire in there. There's also a few pieces of circuit board. And his goal with this stuff is to liberate the metal from the plastic and the waste. We're going to try and recover all the metals and have all the plastic, rubber, and other stuff go into the tailings fraction. So we're going to run it through our 16 by 12 inch hammer mill. It has a quarter inch punch plate screen. All the material is going to flow down onto our shaker table. The metallic fraction will work its way across the table towards me into the number one and number two bin. The plastic and the rest of the waste is going to go down the number three and the number four. Currently, we're trying a new experiment where the number three will report to the hydrocyclone as well. There's a pump in the hydrocyclone that everything that settles down to the bottom gets pumped back up to the hammer mill for recirculation to grind finer. Anything that goes around and floats out into these settling ponds is considered tailings, and there shouldn't be any more metallic fraction in them. This sample, because it's so much wire and rubber and only a little bit of PCB material, I'm going to take the tailing sample right out of the hydrocyclone. There's so much rubber that it'll just pump around the system for a long time to get ground up. The system's really designed to pump only fiberglass and the circuit boards themselves. So we'll try this. We'll run a sample, gather the tailings and the one and the two, and we'll see what we get. Okay, so here's the results from the sample of our shred stuff we ran through the PCB grinder system. And this is the number one material. And we ended up modifying the screen a little bit. I think I told you at the beginning it was a quarter inch punch plate hole, but we ended up modifying it down to about a 2 millimeter wide by about an inch long slot. So we could get a little bit finer grind, a little bit better separation. This is the number two. There's a little bit more aluminum in there, as you can see, but still it's almost all metals. This is just a sample of the number three, kind of the middlings section that we get. And then the number four, it's a little bit hard to see because it's so light it kind of floats, but there's some of the number four plastic and light material that we captured. So I'm going to bag all these up, send them back to the customer so he can check them out. Hope you guys enjoyed the video. And we'll see you on the next one. Thanks for watching.